Hi everyone, my name is Marina and I'm very happy to see you here on my YouTube channel. Today we have a beautiful, slow, flexibility flow for hips. You can call it yin and yang practice because it will be a blissful combination of movement and longer holds of feel-good, deep stretches for the hips. So if you are ready, let's come together in a kneeling position. Close your eyes and take a few moments to focus on your breathing. Slow inhale, followed by a slow exhale. With the next inhale, lift through the chest up. Exhale around into your back. A few more times, continue with cat and cow movements in the seated position. Follow your breathing and try to find the deeper arch through the spine. With the next inhale, lift up onto the knees, easy camel pose. Exhale, sit the hips down, round into your back. Two more times, inhale, lift up, open through the chest. Exhale, round into your back. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, lift up onto the knees one more time. Easy camel. And now a few side bends. Sliding one hand alongside your leg, extending to the side. Back to the center. Onto the other side, keeping the chest open. One more time each way. Beautiful. Interlace the fingers behind the back. Squeeze the shoulder blades closer together. Lift up through the chest. Sit the hips down, fold forward towards the child's pose, lift through the arms, farther over your head, where it feels comfortable for your shoulders. Release the clasp of your hands. Extend your arms forward into the child's pose. Walk your hands over to the left and lift through the chest up into the side bend. Wave-like movement forward and side bend onto the other side. One more time each way. Moving alongside your breathing. Wonderful. Release back and forward into the child's pose. And whenever you're ready, come up into the downward facing dog. If it feels good, slowly walk the feet in place, bending into one knee at a time, and feeling for a good stretch through the back of your legs. Then hold your downward facing dog, connect to your breathing. We'll continue with a few spinal waves. So as you round into your back, shift forward into the plank. Untuck the tailbone, lift through the chest up, shift back and downward facing dog. A few more times. Now round into your back, reach forward. Lower the hips down into the modified upward facing dog. Keep your toes tucked. The hips are hovering above the floor. And lift through the hips up and back, downward dog. Two more times, exhale round into your back, forward. Inhale, lift through the chest up. And push back into downward facing dog. One last time here. Moving slow, finding this fluid, feel good movement through the back. Inhale, lift through the right leg up. Bend the knee, open through the hips, point the right knee up higher. Now come high onto the left tippy toes, hold it here for a moment. Still on the tippy toes, lift through the right leg straight and up, and then transition into full in triangle as you thread the right leg over to the left and open through the chest up. Inhale, come back into one-legged downward facing dog. Exhale, eagle shape as you wrap your right leg over the left. Sit the hips down, you can remain here, or bring your left hand on the outside of the right foot and try to straighten the right leg up. Release the clasp, transition back into one-legged downward facing dog. Exhale. Bring the left knee towards the floor, coming into the gate pose as we lift through the right arm up, open through the chest for a beautiful side body stretch. Exhale, release. Come back up into one-legged downward facing dog one more time. And exhale, step the right foot on the outside of both of your hands. Coming into the lunge, and we'll rock forward and back a few times here. Beautiful. Take a deep inhale into your lunge. Exhale, white pyramid pose. Inhale, forward. Exhale, straighten the right leg. One more time. Exhale, hold your white pyramid. Root through the left hand into the floor, lift through the right arm up, open through the chest. And now try to roll on the outer edges of both feet as we sink the hips down. And come back into the twisted white pyramid pose. A few more times, roll on the outer edges, feeling the stretch through the outer hip on the right side. One more time here. Lift up. And now transition into the side lunge on the right side. Come back into the lunge. A few times moving between the side lunge and lizard lunge position. Wonderful. Pause in a side lunge. Might be go for a side body extension as you lengthen over the left leg and lift through the chest up. The left hip is resting on the floor. And then whenever you are ready, come out of the side lunge and move into the lizard lunge as you bring the left knee towards the floor. Remain on the hands, or if you choose to, lower the forearms down onto the mat. If necessary, use the blocks. We are holding this position for about 1 minute 45 seconds. So use this time to find a deeper connection to the breathing. Continuously let go of any distractions, any thoughts, and allow yourself to relax and sink deeper into the stretch. If you already lift up onto your hands, we'll draw a few circles between the lizard lunge position and half splits. So circling the hips through the side, back into the half splits, and back into the lunge position. Wonderful. Reach your right arm forward. And now in an open twist, try to touch your right hand onto the left hip or behind your back. Three more times. Big circle through the right arm. One last time here. Wonderful. We'll finish the sequence with a quad stretch, so pull the left heel towards the butt, lift up through the chest. Might be you will choose to lower down onto the left forearm. Hold it wherever it feels like a better stretch for the front of your left thigh for you. Release, forearms onto the floor, lift the left knee up and take just a few moments in this dragon variation. Then come up onto your hands, step it back into the plank and go through your vinyasa. We will repeat this sequence on the other side. Inhale, lift through the left leg up. Bend the left knee. Open through the hips and point the left knee up higher. In this position, come up high on the right tippy toes. Maintain the shape. Straighten the left leg up towards the sky. And exhale, fall in triangle. Thread the left leg to the right. And find a little bit more of a back bend as you open through the chest and lift through the hips up. Exhale, release, lift through the left leg up. Now wrap the left leg over the right, sit the hips down, lift through the right arm up. You can hold this position, or if available, try to bring the right hand on the outside of the left foot and straighten the leg up. Well done. Release. Inhale, one-legged downward facing dog. Exhale, bring the right knee towards the floor. Keep your left leg active. Come into the gate pose as you sweep your left arm up. Open through the chest. Engage into the glutes, find a beautiful side body extension. Exhale, release. Let's come up into one-legged downward facing dog one last time. And exhale, step the left foot forward on the outside of your hands. Take a deep exhale and begin to rock the hips forward and back. Sink the hips down and notice the stretch that you're feeling through the front of the right thigh, inner thighs. Slow down your breathing. Now shift back into white pyramid as you straighten the left leg. Bend into the left knee. A few more times. Back into the lunge. Exhale. Inhale, lunge. Come into white pyramid one more time. Lift through the left arm up, open through the chest. And now try to roll on the outer edges of both feet, sink the hips down. Inhale, lift back and up, twisted wide pyramid. Exhale on the outer edges of the feet. We are looking for the stretch through the outside of the left hip. Come up into the white pyramid one last time. And then transition into the side lunge on the left side. Come back into the lizard lunge. And let's move back and forth a few more times. Side lunge to lunge. Beautiful, healthy movement for the hips. Hold the side lunge a little bit longer. Find a position that works for you. Might be extending over the right leg for a side body stretch as we lift through the chest up. Come out. And make your way into the lunge. Bring your right knee down. You can choose to remain on the hands. or bring the forearms towards the mat, if necessary onto the blocks. We hold a lizard lunge position for about 1 minute and a half. If you already come up onto your hands, circle the hips between the lizard lunge position and half splits, straightening the left leg and then bending into the left knee. One more time here. Now bring your left hand forward, forehead down, sweep the left arm up and try to touch either towards the right hip or onto the floor behind you. Three more times, down, up, behind you. Well done. Now bring your left hand towards the right foot for the quad and hip flexor stretch. Take a deep breath, a deep exhale. Try to relax into the hips and pull the heel just a little bit closer towards you. You can try to lower down onto the right forearm. Release the clasp, bring both of the forearms onto the mat or onto the blocks and lift the right knee up. Hold it here just for a moment. Lift up onto your hands and step it back into the plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, lift up, cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Walk your hands towards your feet, feet to the sides of the mat. Come down into the yogic squat. Open the knees wider apart, lift up through the chest and lengthen through the back. Might be choose to close your eyes. Focus on your breathing. Find the stillness in this position. Oh. Walk your hands back forward into the downward facing dog. Now cross your legs, bring the right leg over the left and to the sides of the mat. Bend the knees. Sit the hips down, coming into the shoelace pose for another beautiful feel-good hip stretch. Close your eyes, focus on your breathing, and we hold it here for a total of 1 minute and a half. Lift up onto your hands, shift the weight forward, come up onto the feet. Now turn around. Your left leg comes forward, across over your right leg. Bend the knees, sit the hips down, coming into the shoelace pose on the opposite side. Again, adjust, make sure the heels are on the sides of the hips, not under your hips. Both of your hips are touching the floor. You can remain fully upright or gently fold forward. If necessary, bring blocks under your elbows. Close your eyes. And imagine as if you're melting into the stretch, letting go of any resistance, any fight, allowing yourself to feel it deep in your body and in your heart. What a beautiful stretch, beautiful patience. Come up onto your hands and feet, untangle your legs, and make your way into the downward facing dog. Might be it will feel good to paddle the feet in place. Then inhale, reach through the right leg up and lower down towards the pigeon pose. Keep the hands in front of the right shin. Keep the left toes tucked. Lift the hips up and bring them down. Three more times. Lower the hips down, might be bring the right shin a little closer towards you. We'll take a gentle twist here to be able to square through the hips a little bit better. So bring the left forearm onto the floor, twist to the right, and might be wrap your right hand towards the left hip. Slightly pressing the left hip closer down towards the floor. This is a really helpful, feel-good modification for the pigeon pose that allows to feel a deeper stretch through the right hip. You can remain in this position or reach back forward into the sleeping pigeon. We'll hold it here for another minute. Slowly lift up onto your hands. Tuck the left toes, lift the hips up and make your way into the downward facing dog. If it feels good, circle through the right knee a few times. Wonderful. Bring the right foot down. Might be choose to bend into the knees, paddle it out, rock the hips from side to side. Let's repeat it on the left side. So with the next inhale, reach through the left leg up. Exhale, thread the left shin forward, flex into the left foot, keep the right toes tucked. Lift up and lower the hips back and down into the pigeon. Three more times. One. Two. Three. You can choose to untuck your right toes, whatever feels best for you. Take a moment in the upright position. And now bring your right forearm down, turn over to the left and wrap your left hand behind your back towards the right hip. Notice whether it allows you to square through the hips better. Hold it there a little bit longer or reach forward and try to relax into the sleeping pigeon position. If necessary, remember that you can always place a blanket or a pillow under your left hip if it's not touching the floor, so that you can become a little bit more comfortable and relaxed in this very demanding position for our hips. Slowly come up onto your hands, tuck the right toes, and then make your way into the one-legged downward facing dog, and might be choose to circle through the left knee a few times, bringing back the movement into the hips after holding the stretches for a longer time. Then bring the knees down, sit the hips towards the heels, and let's take a final child's pose for this practice. Close your eyes, melt the stomach towards your thighs, release the forehead towards the mat. Allow yourself just for a few more slow and deep breaths. If you are ready, slowly lift up into the kneeling position. With your eyes still closed, take a few breaths here and notice how you feel. This is the end of our practice. I hope you feel amazing. If you enjoyed this video, remember to hit that like button. Subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss on all the future uploads. Thank you so much for sharing this beautiful time with me on the yoga mat. I cannot wait to see you here again. Take care of yourself and much love.